Did you know that there's an International Soil Day?
What, you guys aren't as excited about dirt as I am?
Dirt does a heck of a lot for us and gets very little credit. In fact, dirt and what lives inside it may be one of the key players to help us with our changing climate. Humans produce carbon dioxide, or CO2, and a lot of it. CO2 is one of the primary greenhouse gases that insulates our planet and contributes to changing climate. Now, there are lots of brilliant minds all over the world focused on how we can reduce the amount of carbon dioxide in our atmosphere. See, once it's released into the air, CO2 can chill out there, making everything a little crazy. And this may come as a surprise, but it also gets absorbed by our oceans, which causes a whole another set of issues. And it can also get absorbed by dirt. Or if we're being technical here, soil. Dirt is the brown dust that's on your shoes after you go for a walk. But soil is what scientists call living dirt. It contains bugs and worms and decaying plants and animals, and microbes. That's right, the soil in your backyard is teeming with life. Just not usually the kind you can see with your naked eye. It's full of bacteria and even viruses, not all of which want to hurt you. Although, some of them do.
Like this guy, for sure.
Most of the time, they are friendly, soil-specific microbes that are just there to chow down on that decaying matter like leaves, so you're good to play around in the mud. But another really important thing that some soil microbes do is absorb carbon dioxide as part of their natural energy cycle. This sounds like it could be helpful, yes? To learn more, Lawrence Livermore researchers, in partnership with a team from West Virginia University, will be conducting research for the next 3 years to improve our understanding of exactly how all this works. They'll be studying how changing the composition of the soil may change the bacteria's ability to absorb CO2. Like, what happens if you add more nitrogen to the soil? Could we optimize the soil's makeup to absorb as much CO2 as possible? Designer soil? One of my favorite parts of this research is that it's got a couple other super cool things going on. It's not just the awesome bacteria in the soil under our feet that absorb carbon. We all know dirt also grows stuff, like trees, for instance. And what do trees breathe? That's right, you guessed it, carbon dioxide. So exploring soil chemistry and how it makes a nice cozy home for these helpful bacteria could also help us optimize soil for growing more trees, so they can help reduce atmospheric carbon dioxide levels too. Apparently, the dirt under some kinds of trees absorbs more carbon than the soil under other kinds of trees.
Why?
This research project hopes to start finding answers to all of those exciting questions. Do you have any questions for the dirt experts? Leave them in the comments down below, and make sure to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook so you can see if we post their answers. Make sure you subscribe to this channel to stay up to date with groundbreaking research like this as it's conducted, and for more videos like this briefing you on the front line of science. You can find some links in the description for even more info on this microbial topic, and check out this video here to learn more about how we're working with algae to create biofuels. Thanks for watching. Speaking of dirt.
Ooh.